Hi, Eric Bakker. I'm back again to talk about enzymes. This time we're going to talk about weight gain and enzymes. It's an established fact, and you can go to Google and have a look. There are various scientific studies that will show you that people who've got enzyme problems end up gaining weight or losing weight, but generally gaining weight. So if you're trying to lose weight, you really want good gut function, particularly good stomach function and pancreatic function. You want to be able to produce lots of lipase, breaks fat down too, so you don't absorb too much fat and store it, you know. So not just fat storage, but carbohydrates obviously can, you know, turn to fat in your body as well. When you've got good enzyme levels, you've usually got good energy levels. Good energy levels go with a good metabolic, a balanced metabolic rate. That means you're going to get off your butt, you're going to do things. The more you move, the more weight you lose. The less you move, the bigger you get. The more tired you get, the more brain fog you get, the more joint pain you get. As you get bigger and become more tired, you get more blood sugar dysregulation, you get more thyroid and adrenal dysfunction, you get hormonal imbalances, and often that will be associated with poor control of lepton and ghrelin and other hormones involved in hunger and appetite control. So very good enzyme levels generally mean very good weight control. So just remember, there's a big link between good enzyme function in your GI tract and your ability to maintain a good metabolic rate, ultimately leading to a balanced weight. And that's what you want. Thanks for tuning in. Look at the next video, please. And if this is the first video you've seen, be sure to look at the preceding videos in these series to get an understanding on the critical importance of good ability, you know, to overcome enzyme deficiency. Thanks for tuning in.